Hello and welcome to another quick tutorial video here from Zenatta Consulting. My name is Tyler Koltz, and in this video, we're going to be walking through the new global sets feature for picklists inside of Zoho CRM. Super helpful, kind of long-awaited feature here to help you standardize some of the data that's in your system. Before we jump in, I do want to ask if you find this video useful, please be sure to like and subscribe down below. That really does help us out. And if you have any questions or feedback or new video requests, please be sure to leave those in the comments section below as we try to read and respond to each and every one of those on our weekly show, Azaz, Ask Zenatta Anything About Zoho. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and jump on into the walkthrough. Right out of the gate, first, I kind of want to explain what these global sets are going to do for us and why they've been a feature that people have been waiting for a long time. So right out of the gate, I'm going to use the example of lead source as we go through this walkthrough. So here, you know, we can see inside of a lead, we've got this pick list for lead source, and it's got a set of options. And then if we go and look at, let's say, a contact, so after we've converted that lead, that also has a lead source with a set of values, right? But what happens when we want to add a new option, right? Let's say we start running Google Ads and we want to have a lead source for, you know, PPC or Google Ads, whatever we want to call it. Well, the challenge is in the old system, you'd have to go into each and every module and add that parameter or add that value there. Right. And so if you added it to leads, it does not automatically add it to contacts, accounts, deals, and so on. And so global sets allow us to basically take a pick list. And again, I'm going to use lead source in this example, but you could do it with any, and create a standardized set of options for that pick list. Right. And so just saves us a lot of time here in being able to add a value to one place and have it show up everywhere. So now we've kind of covered just that high level of why do we care about global sets. Let's actually take a look at where to set them up. So I'm going to jump into settings in the top right. I'm going to go into our modules and fields. There's a couple different ways that you could make a global set. You'll see up at the top, I've got a section here for global sets. And in this case, we've got one existing here for industry. I could come in and create a global set for lead source and pull all the values one by one, right? So essentially add line by line any of the options that I want to have inside lead source. What you'll notice here though is that there is not a section inside of this menu to create a global set from an existing field. And in our case, right, because we have that field already selected and created, we can just use it as our baseline. So I'm going to cancel out. I'm going to go over to our modules. I'm going to open up leads. Really, you could do this in any of the modules where that field exists. So I'm just going to start in leads in this use case. Here, I'll go into edit properties and we'll see all those options that we have. We'll see that this is set currently to a local pick list rather than a global set, meaning these options are only going to be used inside of this module. And here, I can go ahead and convert this to a global set. Let's go ahead and do that. It's going to ask us for a name. So I'll go ahead and call this lead source. And I'll go ahead and save that. We'll notice that when I convert it to a global set, it goes ahead and associates that set back to this field. And what we'll also see is that I can no longer edit these pick list options from right here, right? I've now kind of created them as that global set, meaning they're no longer managed inside of the same place that they were before. So I'll go ahead and save. And as I mentioned earlier, you know, let's imagine this use case where we want to add a option to our global set. So under our submenu here, I can go ahead and open up that lead source. And let's say we wanted to do Google Ads, we can add it here. And then anywhere in the future that that lead source set is used, that option will now appear. So really the last thing that we would need to do is just access any of those modules where that field is used and convert those over to a global set. So I'll show that for contacts, but you will need to do this for each module. So contacts, accounts, deals, right, and so on. So if I go into our contacts list, I'm going to edit our properties. Again, this one is still currently set to local, but I can go ahead and switch it to our global set and associate it with that option that we've already added. So in this case, looks like a couple places are coming in that are that have values in our contacts here that are not existing in the global set, right? So if you have a value in the field and it lines up perfectly, we'll go ahead and auto associate it to that global set value. You might find though that there are a few options in an existing record that don't match, right? And this is pretty common because people have added new lead sources to one place and not the other, right? So in this case, I'm not gonna worry too much about our options here, but you can go ahead and map them across to the appropriate value. And this is one of those opportunities where if you find that there are not good values, close out of this, add them appropriately to that global set and come back. So now I'll go ahead and save that. And so now we've really done kind of all of those core steps. We walked through how to create a global set from scratch, give you a quick demo of creating a global set from an existing pick list, and then showed that process for associating the global set to the remaining pick list where it is applicable. Again, this is kind of a feature a lot of people have been waiting for, so we thought we'd make a quick video walkthrough of how to get this going in your CRM account. If you find this video useful, please be sure to like and subscribe down below. That really does help us out. And please leave those comments, questions, and feedback below in the comments section as we do try to read and respond to each and every one of those. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.